Welcome to the Azure AD Architecture Deep Dive Series. I'm Grace Picking, and I'm a Program Manager on the Azure AD Engineering Team here at Microsoft.
Hello, my name is Wane Inake, and I'm also a Program Manager on the Azure AD Engineering Team.
We are part of the Customer Experience Program, and we help enterprises and businesses from all over the world to deploy our services and get to the cloud. We get a lot of questions about how Azure AD works behind the scenes, so we wanted to share with you the lower level details of our architecture with this series. In this video, we are going to cover a deep dive into self-service password reset, or SSPR.
So Grace, let's get the show on the road. What is self-service password reset?
Self-service password reset is an Azure Active Directory feature that enables employees to reset and change their passwords without needing to contact IT staff. Employees must be registered for self-service password reset before using the service. During registration, the employee chooses one or more alternative authentication methods enabled by their organization.
So, what happens when a user wants to reset their password?
So, the first step is that the user will navigate to the password reset portal by either clicking the Can't Access Your Account hyperlink included in the login screen, in the Office 365 and Azure Access portal, or by navigating to aka.ms/sspr. Once the user has sent this request, we check a few things, such as how should the reset page be localized? Is the user account valid? What organization does the user belong to? Where is the user's password managed? And is the user licensed to use this feature? Once the reset workflow begins here in step 3, the user will have to verify ownership of their account and using the verification steps enforced by the admin. Depending on the verification method set, a user can then select from resetting their password using an alternative email message, text message, phone number, security questions, or using a notification from the authenticator app.
And is this the same for admin accounts?
No. Microsoft enforces a strong default 2-gate password reset policy for any Azure admin role. This policy may be different from the one that you have defined for your users and cannot be changed. You should always test password reset functionality as a user without any Azure admin roles assigned. In step 4, following successful completion of the authorization and authentication request per policy, the user enters a new password. When the new password is entered, Cloud Password Protection gets to work. If you haven't come across Cloud Password Protection before, then it will help eliminate bad passwords in your organization by allowing admins to enforce a global or custom banned password list that will stop users setting passwords that are easy to guess.
What is the difference between the Microsoft banned password list and the custom list?
The Microsoft Global Banned Password List is created by multiple sources, such as real-world telemetry of password spray attacks, and cannot be changed, whereas the custom list is configured by you to fit your organization. In step 5, the password will go through a series of steps to assess its overall strength to determine if it should be accepted or rejected. First, the password is normalized by converting all uppercase letters to lowercase and performing character substitutions such as dollar to S and at to A. Then, matching of the normalized terms is carried out against the banned password lists and substrings such as username or tenant name. Once this is complete, the password is given a strength score based on this algorithm, which needs to be a minimum of 5 points to be accepted. For step 6, once Cloud Password Protection has deemed that the password isn't considered banned and the password can be reset. For cloud users only, the hash of the new password is stored in Azure Active Directory.
Having a cloud-based password reset utility is great, but most companies still have an on-prem directory where the user exists. So how would SSPR work for them?
If you install, configure, and enable Azure AD Connect, then you have the option to enable password writeback. Password writeback is a feature enabled with Azure AD Connect that allows password changes in the cloud to be written back to an existing on-premises directory in real time. Password writeback is supported irrespective of the hybrid authentication method that you have chosen. If this is enabled in your environment, then after the password has passed password protection, then it's now the password writeback agent within your Azure Active Directory Connect infrastructure's time. What it's going to do is make an outbound connection and pick up the request to change in order to publish that back to your Active Directory domain controller. Of course, we need to respect that the password would need to be evaluated against any password policies that you might have set up on your domain controllers. So in step 7, the password writeback agent calls the Win32 native API to set the password against the on-prem AD password policy to make sure that the new password complies with both the cloud and the on-prem password policies.
So what I'm taking away is, first, self-service password reset allows users to change their password and leverage Azure AD password protection to eliminate weak passwords in the cloud and also sync this back on premises. Secondly, the Azure AD Connect password writeback agent should be treated as a critical service and the infrastructure should be protected accordingly. Lastly, SSPR allows you to harness the power of password protection to modernize your password strategy in a way that is more effective than traditional on-prem policies, all alongside your existing policies in Active Directory.
Perfect.
So, how do you recommend organizations deploy SSPR at scale?
It is important to get users registered quickly. By deploying SSPR alongside another application or service in your organization, such as multi-factor authentication. We are currently rolling out a new feature called Combined Registration, which allows users to register their authentication methods once and use them for both multi-factor authentication and SSPR. To find out more information about Combined Registration, go to aka.ms/security-info-docs.
This is really cool, as password management can be a costly exercise for IT admin and can lead to a lack of satisfaction and productivity for users. SSPR enables employees to quickly get unblocked and continue working no matter where they are at the time of the day without having to call the help desk.
Hopefully, you are as excited as we are about SSPR. And if you want to roll out self-service password reset and you want to know how to deploy it, then you can download the Azure AD deployment plans at aka.ms/deployment-plans.
We hope you found this video useful. We will be adding videos on different topics like authentication, provisioning, governance, and many more. If you want to get a copy of the diagrams we used today or want to give us feedback and help us figure out what to cover next, follow the link in the description.
Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to take a look at the rest of the videos in this series.